In the last chapter, you saw how amazing and flexible the Julia array can be. But using all of those features requires a lot of memory, which may affect the performance of your programs. Sometimes you just want a simple, memory-efficient way to handle your data. That's when a tuple comes in handy. As a side note, this data structure can be pronounced either tuple or tuple. I'm going to be referring to it as a tuple. With that said, let's take a look at an example. I'm in VS Code and I've already created a new .jl file. I've also launched the Julia REPL by using Alt-J, then Alt-O. And I've adjusted my user interface so that my REPL window takes up roughly half of my screen. To construct a tuple, use a pair of parentheses, as opposed to a pair of square brackets. So this is an example of a tuple with three elements of type string, int 64, and string. Like an array, you can access an element in a tuple by using an index number. But unlike an array, you cannot mutate the value of any element in a tuple. You'll get an error message if you try to mutate the value of a tuple element. In addition, the order of the tuple element is immutable. You'll get an error message if you try to sort a tuple. Also, you cannot mutate the size of a tuple. You'll get an error message if you try to mutate the size of a tuple. So compared to an array, a tuple is not very flexible. But here's something interesting that you can do with a tuple. In the coding world, what you just witnessed is called a destructuring assignment. So rather than having a single variable name on the left-hand side of the assignment operator, this example has a tuple, which contains three new variable names as elements of that tuple. On the right-hand side is an existing variable name, which also happens to be a tuple, that contains three elements with existing values. Using the syntax, we'll assign the first element in the tuple on the right-hand side to the variable name in the first element in the tuple on the left-hand side, and so on. By doing this, you can now refer to the values in the original tuple by variable names, as opposed to using index numbers. Pretty cool, right? Even though this is useful, there's actually an easier way to refer to tuple elements by name. You can use something called a named tuple, which is the subject of the next chapter.